Yo, what's going on? It's your boy, Brigame27, back again with another video. And ladies and gentlemen, I want to touch up on a topic that was talked about, I believe, over a year ago, but I want to give y'all my two cents on this whole entire retro collecting. And did YouTubers ruin retro collecting? Because, you know, if you just see what I have, you know, I spent over $5,000 with the little collection I had. Like, something like this that y'all see looks like it should cost, you know, maybe a few hundred dollars, maybe, you know, less than a thousand. But just judging by the retro market and what it offers and the supply and demand issues over the years, and with the retro channels blowing up all over YouTube, there's NES the Punk, you got Metal Jesus, you got Angry Video Nerd, and of course you got RGT85. He's still a retro channel, even though he does do a lot of Nintendo Switch. So, calling you out, buddy, I love your retro content more than Nintendo Switch. I know there's a hype train going on, but I love retro gaming. Let's be real. Anyway, let me give y'all a little backstory of myself, in which I kind of, no, I won't say I kind of, I really messed this up. Because back in 2005, in which YouTube was introduced to us in 2005, and I was, let me see, where I was at. I was in college. I was 18 years old. I was 18 years old. And I used to visit this game shop. I forgot the name of it. And I used to see all sorts of retro consoles, accessories, everything in which you will see inside of a retro store right now. But around the time, it was dirt cheap. And around the time, I traded in my Sega Genesis. I had a Sega Saturn. And this is what blows my mind. I had a bunch of Sega Saturn games in which right now I could be getting over $3,000 because of the rarity of those games. Because with Sega and the Sega Saturn, and around that time, a lot of those games didn't sell well, and it's been a few games that sold less than 10,000 copies. So by those games selling that low, in which it increased the value of right now. So basically, of all the stuff that I traded in around 2005, from the Genesis to the Saturn, I had a Dreamcast, I had a 64, and I remember, I believe I got less than $100. I'm trying to remember exactly what it was, but it was less than $100, maybe $80 to $90-something dollars. I had a lot of games and some consoles in which I can basically sell for maybe $3,000 to $5,000 right now. But in 2005, you know, this is when YouTube started, and basically a lot of people wasn't, you know, too much worried about the 8-bit, the 16-bit gaming console, because it was all about that PS2. It was all about that Xbox. It was all about the 3D graphics. Nobody didn't care about 2D gaming no more. And that's what they thought. That's why I believe that the YouTube personalities has a lot to do with the fact that a lot of these retro games are high in the cost. So basically, you know, for instance, you know, if you look at a Commodore 64, look at the Atari Jaguar, the TurboGrafx 16, Neo Geo. Reason why I'm naming these consoles, because these consoles did not sell that well, especially out here in the States. But the TurboGrafx 16, in which is called the PC Engine out there in Japan, was a success. So it's really easy finding a PC Engine / TurboGrafx out there in Japan, because it appealed to that audience, but it did not appeal to the American audience or the European audience. So, you know, if you're trying to look for it, you know, in the States or out there in Europe, it's hard to find. And if you do find it, it costs between $300 to $500. If you want the box set, if you want everything, with the original manual, the plastic, if you want the complete box set of the TurboGrafx-16 or even the Neo Geo, you'll be spending between $500 to $1,000. That's how insanely crazy these prices are. And do I feel pissed because these retro YouTubers, you know, bringing awareness to these games in which they love because they grew up playing these games? Am I pissed off at them because the price of these games that increased, increasingly went up No, I'm not pissed. I'm annoyed that, you know, I had to pay so much money just to get the same experience, or some of these games that I did not get to or play when I was a kid. Now these games cost, you know, hundreds of dollars. You know, it sucks, but I can't get mad at them. Only thing I can do is commend them, because it's bringing a light back into the retro market. It's making a whole bunch of people, kids, even adults, to go back and relive either their childhood or our kids or little cousins, little brothers, sisters, whatever, trying to relive our childhood and experience the games that we played when we was a child. And I love that. I love the awareness on what these big YouTubers bring into the community. And I think that's a great thing. But, you know, it sucks if you want to collect right now. That's why I started collecting, you know, by, you know, let me see, about 2.5 or 3 years ago. Because some of these games that's in my collection right now, I pay maybe, you know, between $30 and $40. But now some of these games is worth almost $100 or even more. So that's why I started collecting a couple of years ago, because I knew that the retro market was going to boom. It was going to explode. Right now it's exploding more than ever. Just look at the fact that we get a whole bunch of these games that's retro inspired. You know, all these indie games is retro inspired. We just got Octopath Traveler is a retro inspired game. You know, even though it's a trip, they priced it at $60. I'm not a big fan of paying $60 for a game that, you know, if you look at it, it's not really a triple A, you know, style game, but it is what it is. It's a very enjoyable game, has a lot of content, so I can't really complain about that, because you will get your hours playing that game. But like I say, man, I love the fact that, you know, we getting the best of both worlds. If you love these realistic type of games, you got that. If you want retro style games, you got that. You want the 8-bit, you want the 16-bit, you want the 32-bit, we got that. You know, whether they're new games or whether they're old games, because we got these really big YouTubers like the Angry Video Game Nerd, in which, you know, spend, you know, a lot of time talking about, you know, bringing a lot of awareness to us, because, you know, it was certain games that I hadn't played when I was a child. And, you know, looking at some of these YouTube channels like Angry Video Game Nerd, Metal Jesus, they bringing awareness to us. And I was like, man, these games look cool. I would love to go back on my Genesis. I would love to go back on the Super Nintendo and, you know, experience these games in which y'all experience now, or, you know, y'all experienced back then. So, yes. It sucks that these games are high in price, but like I say, man, I just want everybody to be happy. You know, if you don't want to collect, you still want to play the game, emulate them. I know that's a big topic right now with the whole entire emulation and Nintendo trying to shut down these sites and, you know, these $100 million losses. I know it's kind of a big thing right now, but will emulation come to an end? I don't think so, because you look at the fact that whenever Napster was a thing, yes, I'm saying Napster, yes, I was old enough to remember Napster, because I remember back in middle school, my uncle used to make me some music on using Napster. Yes, it was free, and, you know, whenever they got rid of Napster, because a whole bunch of music artists felt that they was losing a lot of money, they shut them down. But there was still other sites was popping up everywhere. Napster set a foundation for a lot of people to pirate music. And now the same thing with emulation, people find a way to pirate video games. So whether Nintendo win this lawsuit, or whether some of these sites gonna shut down because they're afraid that they going to, you know, basically get sued, I think it's not going to last very long. People gonna still find a way to emulate games. So people, if you're that mad, then I don't know what else to say. You can find a way to emulate games. Hell, I got an emulator on my PC. If you want it, I can make you a copy. Like, it's easy emulating games. So it is what it is, man. Like, I just want to collect games out of spirit of fun, and it's my hobby. I enjoy my hobby. I love doing this. I want to do more retro videos. So like I say, people, like, you know, YouTube has a big thing to do with the retro games, you know, being very expensive, but it's for a good cause. The only bad cause is the price, the money. It is what it is, man. But like I said, people, y'all give me your thoughts and y'all opinions on how y'all feel about, you know, YouTube ruining the retro market, you know, for people that actually want to collect retro games. You know, so now it's not in our favor to pay, you know, between $5 to $10 or $15 or $20 for a lot of these games. Now they done double, triple, quadruple the price, or even more, you know, because of the huge supply and demand, because of these retro channels are bringing a lot of awareness to these video games. You know, I'm just happy about that because it's shining a light on the games that I love. So y'all, give me your thoughts and your opinions on how y'all feel about this whole entire situation. Like, comment, subscribe to my channel, and hit that notification bell, and follow me on Twitter. And once again, Shaboy Regan 27. Y'all have a good day. Peace out.